Okay, problem one. We are asked to find the distribution function of the uniform random variable which takes the values 1, 2, 3, etc. up to n. So here we have to find out the distribution function of a random variable. So usually you denote a distribution function by what? Capital F of x, right? And that is equal to x less than or equal to small x. Fine. Now here it is said that x follows what? Now onwards, whenever I say x follows, instead of writing FOLOWS, you know, the whole thing, I will give this as a notation. Okay, x follows uniform distribution. Okay, uniform distribution. So in this case, when x follows a uniform distribution, what will be the density function? Now you all know the density function of a uniform distribution. Just recollect it. What is it? 1 by n. And here x takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Now, coming back, we are asked to find out capital F of x, which is equal to probability of x less than or equal to small x, which is equal to summation what? T is equal to 1 to x, t is some integer, F of t, which is equal to, what is F of t? Summation or F of t? 1 by n, which is equal to what? 1 by n plus x times 1 by n. 1 by n. It's not x times, you should, you get this when you open the summation, right? So what is it? X divided by n. So again, we get the what? Probability distribution function. What is it? Capital F of x in this case is x by n. Okay, now our next question is, let x and y be independent random variables such that they have given a condition over here. Okay, now just closely observe the condition. Probability of x is equal to r is equal to probability of y is equal to r, which is equal to q raised to rp. Now, what kind of distribution is that, q raised to rp? Yes, geometric distribution. So there is a condition. Then, p and q are positive signs. Then the range of r is also given, p plus q is equal to 1. Okay, now these are the information that is given to us. Now what is the question? That is the important. Find the distribution function of x plus y, first question. Then also you have to find out the conditional distribution function or the conditional probability of x given x plus y is equal to 3. Okay, now this question might be a bit, you know, big in when you see, but it's actually very easy when you break this down. Okay, so let's move on to the solution. Okay, now let us find out the, I'm really sorry, this was not a distribution. You are not asked to find out the distribution function. You are asked to find out the density function of x plus y. So now let us consider a random variable z, which is equal to x plus y. Okay, now we will write, we know that the how do you write the PDF as z, probability of what, z is equal to x plus y, right? You can write like this. Now this is same as what, f of z, right? Now I'm going to consider probability of x plus y is equal to z. I hope this is okay for you. Now this is equal to probability. Now I'm going to split this up. Okay, so summation what, r is equal to 0 to z, probability of x is equal to r comma y is equal to z minus r. Now you will be wondering, how did I get this from this line? Okay, now you see x takes the value 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. and y takes the value 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. and you are given x plus y is equal to z. So when x takes the value 0, y takes the value z. X takes the value, when you put this 0 over here, you can get, you will get y is equal to z over here. When x takes the value 1, you get y is equal to z minus 1, and so on. When r is, when x takes the value r, you get y is equal to what, z minus r. So this is a general term. So that is what I just gave it over here. I just opened this up and I just substituted it. That's all. Okay, now this is equal to, now let's see, Now I am going to write this as summation r is equal to 0 to z, probability of x is equal to r multiplied by probability of y is equal to z minus r, which is equal to, now what is this probability of x is equal to r, summation r is equal to 0 to z, what is this? X follows, you all know x follows a geometric distribution, so what is this? Q raised to rp. And what about this? Q raised to z minus rp, right? Okay, I hope you understood till here. Yes, I just took it like this, that is f of z is equal to summation z is equal to 0 to r q raised to rp into q raised to z minus rp. Now this is equal to, I am going to take this p, here I have one p and there is also a p, so I am going to take this p square outside, so p square into summation z is equal to 0 to r, then what is left? Q raised to r, q raised to z minus r, so which is equal to p square summation z is equal to 0 to r, you get what, this get cancelled, q raised to z. Now z takes the values from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. Okay, so when I open up this summation, what will I get? P square. I will get, when I open up this, what, how many terms I will get regarding q raised to z? Z plus 1 terms, okay, into q raised to z. If you have any doubt, you can open this up. Now this is your, what, density function of f, density function of z, or density function of x plus y. I hope all of you have understood. Just go through the video once again and then take down your notes. Okay, so now we will have to find out what is f of x given x plus y is equal to 3. Now we can write, instead of x plus y, you can write z, that is f of x given z is equal to 3. So again I am going to rewrite this as f of x comma z divided by f of z, that is equal to probability of x is equal to x comma z is equal to 3 divided by probability of z is equal to 3. I hope you all understand this, right? Have you got this? Okay, now here, see, just converting this into the probability terms, that's all. Okay, then that is equal to, now this I'm going to split it as probability of x is equal to x. Now this one, probability of z is equal to 3, instead of z is equal to 3, I'm going to write y is equal to z minus 3. Now I hope you all know why I'm going to write like that. Why? Just take a few moments earlier, you will find out the reason. Okay, so that's, so you have to go and look for the reason why I wrote y is equal to z minus 3 divided by probability of z is equal to 3. Now this is in a stage like this. Okay, now again you will have to keep in mind a result that you got earlier when you were asked to find out, where you were asked to find out what is the density function of z. Now the density function of z, after your calculations, you got it as p square into z plus 1 into multiplied by q raised to z. This was the answer that you got for the density function of what? Z. Right. Now, keeping this in mind, you are going to apply this over here. When you apply this over here, now the first one, that is probability of x is equal to x, you don't have to worry because x follows a geometric distribution. You can write it as q raised to x p. In this case, you can write it as, in the case of y, y also follows a geometric distribution, you can write it as what, q raised to 3 minus x into p. Okay, instead of x, you have z minus 3. Sorry, it's not 3 minus z, it is z minus, okay. So here, earlier I have written something wrong. So now I have corrected it. It is y is equal to 3 minus x. Okay. Now again, when you so this one you will go, have to go and calculate how you got this. Okay. Now coming back, instead of probability of y is equal to 3 minus x, you can write what q raised to 3 minus x into p. The whole divided by what is probability of z is equal to 3. Now this is probability of z is equal to 3. In the other two cases you clearly know that that is a geometric distribution. Now in the case of z, you already found out the density function, so you have to apply this over here in this denominator. So by applying you get p square same as that, the as it is, z plus 1. Z plus 1 instead of z, what can you write? Here z is equal to 3, no? So you can write here as, instead of z you can write it as 4, then q raised to 3. Now if you cancel out, there are so many terms that you can cancel over here, and after that you will get the answer as 1 by 4. Now where did you come from? You came from here, that is the density function of x given x plus y is equal to 3 is 1 by 4. Now do you think what kind of distribution this will be? 1 by something. Yes. Now this is similar to your uniform distribution. Okay, next problem. Okay, here we are going to toss 8 coins. 8 coins are tossed 256 times. In how many tosses do you expect at least one head? Okay, so here you are asked to find out the number of tosses where you get at least one head. So this is what you have to find out. For that, first we will consider the probability of getting at least one head. So now what is the probability of getting at least one head? Now for this you have to bring back your probability distribution, probability concept to your mind. What was p of a is equal to? The number of favorable cases divided by total number of cases. Exactly here also you are going to apply that. So here let's keep the number of favorable cases at a side. What about the denominator? Number of total cases, right? So number of total cases, and you guys are very much lucky that in your question you have this total number of cases. What is it? 256. What about this? This is a favorable case, right? So what is this? The number of cases where you get at least one head. Okay, now this is the favorable case. Now from this you can, so this and your numerator over here both are equal. So if you know this part and if you know the denominator, you can easily find out the number of cases or the number of tosses where you get at least one head. So that is how you solve the answer. So let's rewrite this equation as number of cases where, or if you are not comfortable with cases, you can write number of tosses. Where you get at least one head is equal to probability of at least one head multiplied by number of total cases. Now as I said, you are lucky enough that this you know, it is already 256. The remaining is okay. So now we know that the total number of cases is 256, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to define a random variable x. Now what is the random variable x? The random variable x is the number of heads obtained in 8 tosses. Okay, we have 8 coins. So when I flip one coin, that means one toss. So similarly, when I flip 8 coins, that means 8 tosses. So x knows the number of heads obtained in 8 tosses. Now we know that x. Now it is assumed that x follows binomial distribution. Okay, so since this is how I write binomial distribution, this is a notation. I hope you remember that. And this is, instead of follow, I just wrote it like that. Okay, now x follows binomial distribution, and since x follows, we assume that since x follows binomial distribution, our f of x is equal to ncx p raised to x q raised to n minus x. Now in this case, what is your n? 8 cx. Instead of p, you can write 1 by 2 raised to x. P means what? You get, it is possible that you can get either a head or a tail. Okay, so the probability of getting a head is 1 by 2 the raised to x, then 1 by 2 raised to n minus x. Right, so this is the density function with regards to this particular case. Now we are asked to find out what probability of getting at least one head, right? So what is it? That is equal to probability. Now it is noted that x can take the values 0, 1, 2, etc. up to 8. Since x means what? The number of heads obtained in the 8 tosses. So this thing you should keep in mind. So keeping that in mind, what is the answer for this? You can write it as x is equal to 1. First, probability of, there is a chance that x is will be equal to 2. There is a chance that x will be equal to 3. Plus etc. up to probability of x is equal to 8. Now, you can give your substitutions as it is, but for my convenience, I'm going to write it as 1 minus probability of x is equal to 0. I hope you all are fine with this. So, we know that probability of at least one head is equal to what? 1 minus probability of x is equal to 0. Now, that is equal to 1 minus, what is probability of x is equal to 0 when you apply your binomial distribution? Yes, 8 c 0, 1 by 2 the whole raised to 0, 1 by 2 the whole raised to 8 minus 0, which is equal to 1 minus. Now you do some calculations over here, you will get 1 by 2 the whole raised to 8, which is equal to 1 minus 1 by 256. That is equal to what? What is it? Yeah, 255 divided by 256. So that is the probability, that at least you will get one head. That is the probability, and that is 255 divided by 256. Now, are you finished with the problem? No. What were you asked to find out? The number of tosses. Now, let's see what is the number of tosses. Now, as per your there was a formula that we formulated in the beginning of the solution, right? Do you remember that formula? Okay, if you have written down somewhere, please note that. So according to that formula, what is it? Now I'm going to just move this and write. Therefore, the number of tosses is equal to what? The probability of getting at least one head. So what was the answer that we got? 255 divided by 256 multiplied by the total number of tosses. What is it? 256. Now you cancel this, and this is the answer. Okay.